Good morning, students. How are you? Okay, thank you very much. I'm also fine. Today, we are going to teach you passive narration. It is one of the question items of your question paper. Okay, so I strongly believe that you have learned much about Dieter's narration. So, while doing the passive narration, you will take the help of Dieter's narration. Okay, so first look at the whiteboard. Here I have written a passage, short passage. The teacher said, "What are you doing here, Rana?" Okay. Rana replied, "Sir, I am waiting for my friend. He will attend the class with me. Thank you. Come to my class timely." Okay. So, from the passage, we can see some sentences. First, we see the teacher said, "What are you doing here, Rana?" The teacher said, "What are you doing here, Rana?" This is an interrogative sentence. Okay. Next, Rana said, "Sir, I am waiting for my friend. You will attend the class with me." Rana said, "I am waiting here." This is assertive sentence. He also said that he will attend the class with me. This is also assertive sentence. Next, the teacher said, "Thank you. Come to my class timely." This is imperative sentence. So while changing passage narration, you will think the all Dieter sentences, assertive, interrogative, imperative, optative, and exclamatory. When you read the passage, you will get maximum types of sentences in the passage. Okay. So in the passage, first you will read and think about the speaker and the listener. When you will see the speaker at the very beginning of the sentence, you have more or less then, and you will write the first speaker, then you will change the reporting part according to the reported speech. If the reported speech assertive sentence, you will change the reporting part said into told. Okay. If the reported speech is interrogative sentence, you will take the help of asked. That means you will write asked instead of reporting verb said. Okay. Then instead of comma and inverted comma, you will write that if the reported speech assertive sentence. Okay. But you see, here reported speech is interrogative sentence. So you need not write that here. Okay? Because here is interrogative pronoun, and you will write interrogative pronoun just after the object. Okay? Then you will change the subject of the reported speech. If the subject of the reported speech is second person, first person, second person, like this, then if the subject of the reported speech is second person, you will think about the object or listener. Okay. So here is Rana is the object. So you will write he instead of Rana. Okay. Then change the tense, because the reporting part of the reporting part of the passage is past tense. So you will change the tense. So while changing tense, you think which tense is here. If the tense is present indefinite tense, you will write past indefinite tense. But in the passage you see that the tense is present continuous tense. So you will take the help of past continuous tense. This is why I have written, the teacher asked Dana what he was doing. What he was doing? Are you doing what he was doing? He has been coming to there. Okay. I think you have understood the first sentence. Then second sentence. In reply, Rama is telling to his teacher, "Sir, I am waiting for my friend. I am waiting for my friend." You see, inverted comma, "Sir, then I am waiting for my friend." Okay. Here you see present continuous tense. And at the very beginning of the sentence, we see "Sir," the respective word. Okay. So, while writing the answer, I have written, Rama respectfully. Instead of "Sir," we have written, Rama respectfully replied. Because Rama is telling something in reply of his teacher. Okay. So, Rama respectfully replied that. You see, "I am waiting for my friend." This is assertive sentence. So, we are going to write that as a conjunction. Okay? So, Rama replied that he was waiting. I am waiting. Present continuous tense will turn into past continuous tense. Okay? He was waiting for his friend. He was waiting for his friend. But Rama is telling another sentence. "He will attend the class with me." So, we can write here "and added that," or if we use data sentence here, "he added that." That means Rama added that. Okay. So, "he added that," he, that means Rana's friend. Rana's friend, we will turn into would, because the reporting verb is past tense. Okay? Would attend the class with him. Class with him. Me first person, so me will turn into him. Then the teacher said, "Thank you. Come to my class." In the inverted comma, you see, this is the speech of the teacher, but after the speech or before the speech, there is no mention of the pronoun or noun, like teacher or him, there is no mention. But you have to understand after reading the passage that whose speech is this. Okay? Sometimes you get such type of sentence in the passage narration. So, it is clear to you that this speech is given by the teacher. Okay. So, the teacher thanked Rama. "Thank you." This is an imperative sentence. So, if the imperative sentence is started with "thank" like this, so we do not need any reporting verb here. We will use "thank." Okay. The teacher thanked Rana. You means Rana. So we are writing Rana instead of you. "Come to my class kindly." This is another imperative sentence. So while changing the sentence, you can use "and told him." If you do not like to join the sentence, you can write "the teacher again told him." The teacher again told him that the teacher again told him to come to his class timely. Okay? Or you can join the sentence by using "and." Okay? So the teacher thanked Rana and told him to come to his class timely. So I think suffix is clear to you. In this way, you can see many, many sentences in the same passage. Okay? And you can take the help of changing narration, following the rules of passage narration. Okay, thank you very much. Next, we will meet again.